CS50 Live first looks today at GitLab. GitLab is a popular source code hosting site, much like GitHub.com, that developers can use in order to store their code centrally in order to version control it, save multiple copies, as well as share it with other users. Unfortunately, GitLab ran into a bit of an issue very recently, whereby the whole incident started when they saw this. They support a feature known as snippets, whereby users can create snippets of code, much like GitHub gists, whereby users can upload small snippets of code to share them with other people. Unfortunately, having some 1.5 million snippets of code created over the course of just a few days, not normal. In fact, this seemed to be the result of some spammy behavior by some adversarial folks online. Moreover, GitLab also noticed that one or more spammers seem to be using GitLab inappropriately as a content delivery network, or CDN, whereby they were serving up files in ways that they shouldn't. Now, unfortunately, these kinds of attacks resulted in a bit of a ripple effect on their backend databases. Particularly, GitLab posted the following: "We are experiencing issues with our production database and are working to recover." Now, unfortunately, just minutes later did they post, "We accidentally deleted production data and might have to restore from backup." Now, what exactly happened? Well, it's quite common for databases to be replicated from one to another so that you have a primary and a secondary, the latter of which is a backup of the former in real time. As part of the diagnosis a challenge for figuring out why the databases were slowing down in terms of this replication, one of GitLab's system administrators very deliberately executed a command quite like this. Now, what is this command? Well, at the front of this command is sudo, which says execute the following command with administrative or root privileges. What is the command to be executed? Well, rm-rf, apparently. And rm, you might know, is to remove files or folders from a system. -r, though, means recursively. Delete the following thing recursively so that any directories inside of that also get deleted. And unfortunately, the f in -rf means forcibly, which means don't even prompt the human to confirm or deny that he or she wants to do this. Now, the system administrator meant to execute this command deliberately on their secondary database, db2.cluster.gitlab.com, so that they could resume then the replication from their primary to their secondary database. Unfortunately, it appears to have been late at night. This was a stressful situation. And darn it, if this command weren't executed on db1.cluster.gitlab.com, the actual primary database. Now, no big deal. Surely we have backups all over the place, so we can just restore from backup, and our customers will be perfectly happy and on their way. Unfortunately, out of 5 backup or replication techniques deployed, GitLab reported that none are working reliably or set up in the first place. Indeed, if you'd like to read their whole postmortem in which they discussed exactly what went wrong and how, you can check out this URL here. But the moral of the story for our purposes is please, please beware the rm-rf, especially if you're not just deleting some directory of your own, potentially your customers as well.